one anyway.
Yeah.
There we go.
Ghost Inside, hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Welcome back to Download.
Thank you.
Last time you were here, what year was that? 2016?
You were the closest of the day. It was 2015.
15.
Yeah.
All right. That was a long time ago.
Yeah, it's been a minute. And actually, Download was our last show that we played in the UK prior to the bus accident and everything else. So pretty full circle to come back and have our first show back over here be at Download, back in the 10th stage. Kiss is headlining on the main stage. So it's a really, really big, like, emotional moment for us to be here today.
Yeah.
Beautiful day, packed place, too, that could not be better.
You played?
Night.
Oh.
Eight?
Eight?
Oh, you're on eight as well?
Yeah.
Eight-ish?
Everyone playing at eight? Skindred at eight? Oh, wait, no, they're not. They're five. Ignore me. I'm talking shit.
We'll forgive you.
Thanks. Yeah, last time you were here, actually, we spoke to your drummer. Obviously, he had the accident, but he's back in the band. Is he playing with you today?
Yeah, he was never not in the band, but, you know.
Physically.
Oh, yeah. He's here. He's over there with our singer, Vigil. But, yep, same guys, same crew. A little more weathered, but we're happy to be here.
Yeah, 7 years is a long time when you're in your 30s, no matter what. So all physical stuff aside, we're just like, man, we're in the van on the way over here feeling every bump, every like, oh, I got to stretch my knee. Who brought the Theragun?
How's that affecting the music then?
To be honest, I think it's made us better players because we've spent so much more time practicing and caring about the craft now, whereas when we were younger and of full health, you just take it for granted. You know, you're playing 200 shows a year and you don't care as much about the craft at home. And I know, like, Zach's got a riff room at his house where he plays every day. I play in my office.
A riff room?
It's a little riff room, yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, thank you. But, yeah, like he was saying, and now we're able to play later in the day, have a little production, and focus on playing more songs better and having fun.
Okay, more production. You got more production on stage?
Today we won't have the full show, but it'll still look really nice up there.
Okay, nice. So you save the full show for your show.
Yeah, so we're playing at Brixton next Saturday. Ooh. And that one will be pretty off the charts.
Nice. How long's that for? How long's your set?
I think tonight we're about an hour. At Brixton we'll get closer to hour and a half, I think.
Nice, that's good. What's your staple time for a set? Hour and a half?
Lately an hour and five, hour ten.
Yeah, somewhere in there. Long enough that you get your money's worth, but not long enough that we get bored.
I do think an hour's actually quite nice. You've warmed up, you've loosened up, and it doesn't start to drag. You don't start thinking, is the oven on?
Yeah. Well, we all know how it works, too. Towards that end of the hour where you might start getting tired, you know the big stuff's coming, so it gives you that last little kick, and then we can all go ice or knees.
Yeah, you front load the set list with all the duds, save the studs for the end, so that way, like, nobody's going to leave before you play your biggest song. So it's a mental game. We're all playing it.
Great, there's some top tips there. Speaking of which, actually, what advice would you give to a young band to get them where you are now?
It's so hard for young bands now because the industry has just totally changed. Everything is like, not even can you have a viral song, but can you have a viral chorus of a song that goes on TikTok and Kim Kardashian remixes it and whatever. So I don't know. I don't know how we would survive in today's like social media climate. So I think it's more important than ever to just make music that you really love and do it because you're passionate about it and not shoot for some specific success, but do it because you love it, and if it works out, you're double lucky.
You got to be genuine and honest about it.
Yeah, and I mean, social media is huge, obviously. It's very important for bands, but the end of the day, having a great live show and getting out and playing to people, that'll never be replaced. Yeah, we've seen it tried to, you know. Everyone's here, we're not on Zoom. So just get out there and play shows.
That's it. Because at the end of the day, it is your live show that's got to hold up. You can have a million subscribers, but
yeah, exactly.
If you haven't got a good show, they're not going to buy a million tickets.
Yep.
You know, we played a festival in Texas where you see some people who literally, they have a million followers, but the crowd wasn't quite there, you know? So social media is big, but it doesn't mean there'll be people singing along with you. So, yeah. We're old.
Yeah, we're not jaded, but we're right next. Whatever's next door to jaded, we're there.
Yeah, we're a couple 5 years from it. Like we both printed flyers and handed them out to people, as I'm sure everyone here is familiar with.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah.
I don't know if kids know what printer is now.
I kind of miss it. It was so simple, you know?
Face to face as well.
Yeah.
That was interacting with your fans and the scene as well.
Yeah.
But then you get to a certain level, you're too big for that.
You're never too big for anything, and I think that's one of the parts that long-term success requires, that you, like, keep some humility, you know? Like, there's... You know, for every person on this side of the fence, there's 100 people on that side of the fence that paid their hard-earned money. They made plans. They got babysitters. They're going to sleep in a tent, you know, just to see bands play. And we can never, ever take that for granted. You know, like, we're here to entertain these people, and we're obligated to go do a good job. Like, this life is crazy. No one deserves this. No one is promised this. So you got to really enjoy it and make the most of it. And, a big part of that is, you know, appreciating the fans. And, you know, like when you see someone at Nando's taking a picture with them, not sharing your peri peri sauce, that's fucked up. But
wow. One halloumi stick, maybe. Just one.
So you're going to watch Kiss tonight, then?
I'm not sure what time our shuttle out of here is.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're headed to Paris tomorrow. So if we can catch part of them, we'd love to, because that's what we did last time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess you're on at 8, so yeah, you'll finish by the time they are about to start, because no one plays at the same time.
Yeah, I think so. Yep.
Yeah, you can imagine. You got crew.
Yeah. Yeah.
If we can make it over there, we will.
Yeah. We'll see some flames for sure.
Yeah. You can do the 3-song rule.
Yeah, exactly. You get it.
Yeah. All right, cool. Well, thank you for talking. I'll let you get on with your evening.
Cool. Thanks for having us.
Do you eat before you play?
Zach, how was your dinner?
It was great. I ate half of it and threw it away to come here.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's fine. It's our first press back.
Oh, well, hopefully you get something nicer afterwards.
Yeah. We'll take care of it.
Cool. All right. Thank you very much. Have an awesome set.
Thanks, awesome. Xander.
See you later.